This model of an MAN TGX tractor and Goldhofer trailer is in the colours of Senn AG, a Swiss engineering company. It comes in a standard Conrad branded box and has a helpful sheet of instructions which describe the many configurations of the trailer, although not all options appear. The model's contained within quality foam rubber packing, and that includes the tractor. Packed with a gooseneck is a bag of parts, and that contains many bits and pieces for both the trailer and the tractor. The main deck unit is fully assembled, and among the other parts are the Goldhofer modules, and this model contains a 6-line module and a 4-line module. In this assembly section, we'll just cover the fitting of the parts to the tractor, and as usual you need to separate the mirrors and roof aerials from their mouldings. The door mirrors just fit into place, but for the passenger side mirror, there's a small mirror just to add on to the frame first, and if you add that, you can then fix it into the holes on the doors, and if you line it up right, you can just press the mirror in, and it's just about tight enough that it holds its position once you fix it firmly in place. The aerials fit into holes on the cab roof, but I think the aerials supplied with the review model aren't quite the right ones because they look like side-mounted aerials rather than ones that should be standing up. Underneath the MAN, the detail is typical Conrad. The rear axles have got very good detailing, but the steering is purely functionally modelled. The wheels have different tyres on the front and rear axles, and they're nicely detailed with the wheel nuts clearly visible. The MAN tractor looks really good in the colours of Senn AG with colour-coded door mirrors, and on the front bumper there are some nice chevron graphics, and there's a good towing hitch. The graphics are applied really well, and although there's no number plates on the model, it's good to see a fleet number on the door. At the rear, the wheel arches are plastic, the lights have lenses, and there's a single towing hitch. Behind the cab is a metal equipment tower, and there's a really nice mesh-covered fan on the top. Both Goldhofer modules have the same details. There are good tyres mounted on plastic axle assemblies, and the structure of the module is modelled well. The trailer gooseneck is a heavy metal part with a textured surface and metal handrails. The graphics on the gooseneck are good and sharp, but there's no yellow reflective stripe along the edges of the trailer. The heavy construction of the trailer components is modelled well, and the paint finish is nicely applied. At the rear, the lights on the panel are painted. There's some good Goldhofer graphics, but a number plate would have added some nice detail. Putting the MAN onto the test track, then, as you would expect, it rolls very well in a straight line. And picking it up, it's a typical Conrad chassis. There's some float in the rear axles to represent suspension. The two steering axles are linked together and they do steer. You can set them to really a very hard lock, but if you do that, you find that the model won't really roll at all because the wheels are fouling the wheel arches. But at least you can pose it with the wheels turned sharply. The cab of the tractor tilts, but it's got limited movement, and on the review model it wouldn't stay in a tilted position. The Goldhofer units are the typical modules used by Conrad on a number of their models. There's lots of up and down movement possible in the axle assemblies. And in terms of steering, it's very good. On the 6-line module, the rear three axles steer proportionately, as do the front three, and they're all linked and turn very well. And if you set them, you can then have the module move in a very nice and realistic looking arc. The main strength of this Goldhofer trailer is the many configurations it can be built in. So we'll start by just assembling it in a short configuration with the two Goldhofer module units joined together. We'll start by adding the rear lights onto the back of the trailing module, and it's quite a tight fit because of the thicknesses of paint involved, but it's a firm fit once it's put in. The next step is to join the two Goldhofer module units together, and that's best done upside down when you can interlock the locking holes and put a plastic pin into place and push it through, and it's usually a pretty good fit. Might be a little bit tight, but it just pushes in and joins the two parts together quite solidly. Next up is to fix the gooseneck onto the front of the trailer, and that's a matter of lining up the pins on the gooseneck into the holes into the trailer, and that's a push fit, and it's probably tight enough almost on its own, but again you can install a locking pin on the underside by pushing it through the holes that join the gooseneck and trailer together. Once that's been done, you can turn the trailer back over And at that point you can see that there is some movement between the gooseneck and the trailer possible. You can get a different angle there because the cylinders that control it do work and they're quite stiff. And then we can hook up the gooseneck onto the tractor unit and we've got our first trailer combination formed. This configuration of the trailer is really designed to carry heavy loads, so set up like this we can carry a large heavy fabricated beam. The next possibility is to add the deck unit between the two modules, so we just need to unpin the module connection and separate them out, and then we can insert the deck unit between them. There are various parts supplied with the model depending on how you want to configure it, and all the connection arrangements are the same, they just push into place and you can secure them with a pin on the underneath if you need it to be a bit tighter. And once you've done that on both ends of the trailer, then you can just hook up the deck onto the front and you've then formed a low loader type arrangement. There are some plastic deck sections supplied and these just drop into place between the two beams, and when you pop them in you've got a standard low loader deck. Another possibility is to extend out the deck, and when you do that you get a really impressive model that's about 67 centimeters long. But the flexibility doesn't end there, because you can also make the deck wider and it just pulls apart. It's controlled by little hydraulic cylinders and they can be quite stiff, but you can just pull them apart. And Conrad also supply various lengths of plastic beams, and these just clip into place to maintain an even deck width. The configuration shown here is the widest configuration, but you can narrow the beams right down to a very narrow spine beam configuration. With a wider deck configuration you can carry a different type of load, so here we've got some kind of industrial load. And the flexibility of the model just gives the ability to display it in different and interesting ways. And here's a quick look at another possibility, which is a very narrow beam arrangement. These Goldhoffer models always provide an interesting display, and in the colours of Sen AG it certainly looks impressive. The details, features and flexibility are fine, and it's good enough to be highly recommended.